Thanks for joining us in NewsSentinel.com. I'm Tom Davis, a sports editor with the New Sentinel, joined by Comets beat writer Blake Sebring. And Blake, let's take a look back at the last couple of
Do we have to?
With Fort Wayne. They're 7-5 after 13 games, and you wrote a column today about their lack of discipline. Talk a little bit about what you've seen lately.
It's like they've forgotten what they were supposed to do. And I'm not talking discipline with the penalties, but I'm talking discipline also with the way that they are approaching what they're supposed to be doing. They took way too many penalties, and it wasn't even, like Coach Sim says, I can't even argue with the calls because they were the penalties. They were the calls. And guys were just losing their cool, and the other teams were playing smarter than the Comets, which is, and again, this has become a problem at home. On the road, they are a completely different team.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. That's what's part of it is, you know, on the road, they fall behind by a goal. They just, no problem. We'll get it back. At home, they fall behind by a goal. They panic. It becomes much more pressurized. The fans are less patient, and partly because the players aren't giving them anything to be, you know, excited about.
Right.
These were two of the most boring games. Well, they were the two most boring games of the year this weekend, and it's just they just don't do what they've been taught to do.
Is this part of the Comets' annual, we'll wait until the new year to really kickstart our season, and then we'll play lights out from that point
on? But the thing is, they were 7-2-1, which was the best start ever under Al Simms. I mean, it just doesn't compute in some ways. And granted, they do have a lot of injuries. I mean, they have six guys out right now, if you count Nick Schaus, who went to Norfolk, and then there are five guys right now who would be on the injured list if they had anybody else to take their spot, and there's nobody else to take their spot right now.
Okay, well, looking ahead at this week, what's on tap for this week with Fort Wayne?
They're playing Kalamazoo, and then they're playing Kalamazoo, and then they're playing, I believe it's Evansville or Toledo. I can't remember. I think that's part of the problem, is that they're so used to playing these teams. Teams know exactly what each other's going to do. So it's like, if you don't do exactly what you're supposed to perfectly, the other team can exploit it. And I think that's part of the problem. I think it'll do the Comets a lot of good when they go on the road next week, after this week, when they go to Gwinnett, and then they go to Orlando the week after that.
Just to see different faces.
See different faces, and it's somebody who doesn't know them as well as these teams know them, and maybe that'll help let them relax a little bit and just trust the system and work at it.
Well, nobody likes playing on the holidays better than the Comets because for no other reason it makes Blake work every single holiday. But it's a Fort Wayne tradition on Thanksgiving night to stuff yourself with turkey, watch a little bit of football, take an afternoon nap, and then
yeah, for everybody but me, thanks. Yeah,
for everybody but you, because you've got to go work. But Thanksgiving evening, what time is the puck drop?
7:30.
7:30 at the Coliseum. Thanks for joining us today. You can follow Blake Sebring on Twitter at Blake Sebring and at his blog, Tailing the Comets. And there's a lot of information, fights, stats, everything you'd ever want to see there. Follow him along. He'll bring you the best Comets coverage all season long.